For centuries, sanitation has been a key factor in improving public health and preventing disease. From the development of clean water systems to modern waste management, advances in sanitation have played a critical role in shaping healthier communities around the world. Hi, I'm Joe Brown. Welcome to a journey through the fascinating history of sanitation. From ancient waste management practices to the modern infrastructure we rely on today, sanitation has shaped how we manage hygiene and public health. Here, we're going to take a brief look at the history and ultimately answer, how does sanitation work and why is it important for public health? Our story begins in ancient civilizations, where the first recorded efforts to manage sanitation were crucial in protecting public health. In the Indus Valley civilization, for example, urban centers featured some of the earliest examples of sophisticated drainage systems and private baths, ensuring that waste was disposed of properly to prevent contamination. These advancements are seen in cities like Mohenjo-Daro, where even private homes had their own sewage systems, an impressive feat for the time. In ancient Egypt, clean water sources like the Nile River were carefully managed to ensure safe drinking water, with early forms of water filtration methods used to make water cleaner. Egyptians were among the first to recognize the importance of maintaining clean water and managing waste, even building public latrines and drainage systems in their urban areas. Now, the Romans took these ideas further, constructing elaborate aqueducts to bring fresh water into their cities and building large public bathhouses that served as both places of hygiene and social gathering. The Roman Cloaca Maxima, one of the world's earliest sewer systems, helped channel waste away from the city of Rome, improving sanitation and public health. During the medieval period, Europe experienced a significant decline in sanitation, with limited access to clean water, poor waste management, and minimal public health measures contributing to high mortality rates during pandemics. The bubonic plague claimed the lives of 25 to 30 million people in Europe, about one-third of the entire population, devastating communities and highlighting the critical need for improved public health systems. In contrast, the Islamic world experienced a golden age of scientific, medical, and public health advancements. Cities like Baghdad, Cordoba, and Cairo were renowned for their advanced sanitation systems, which included water distribution networks and public baths called hammams. The Hammam al-Shifa in Cairo is an iconic example of Islamic bath architecture, featuring a series of rooms with progressively warmer temperatures heated by a subfloor heating system known as a hypocaust. During the Renaissance, sanitation efforts began to take on a more organized and systematic approach, particularly in urban centers. Pope Sixtus V, during his papacy from 1585 to 1590, initiated one of the first large-scale urban sanitation projects in Rome, focusing on the Felice Aqueduct. This engineering feat brought fresh water to the city, improving sanitation and providing clean drinking water to the population. The Industrial Revolution in the 18th and 19th centuries introduced rapid urbanization, leading to overcrowded cities and poor sanitation. This exacerbated public health problems, particularly during cholera outbreaks. The cholera pandemics of the 19th century brought sanitation into sharp focus. John Snow's work during the 1854 London cholera outbreak helped establish the link between contaminated water and disease transmission. His innovative use of mapping to track the spread of the disease marked a major turning point in understanding the importance of sanitation in preventing epidemics. Sanitary reformers like Edwin Chadwick championed the need for systematic sanitation systems. Chadwick's Report on the Sanitary Condition of the Laboring Population of Great Britain highlighted the link between unsanitary living conditions and disease. This eventually led to the passage of the Public Health Act of 1848, which began the process of urban sanitation reform across Britain, including the development of sewage systems and better waste management. Through the 20th century, pioneers like Abel Wolman advanced water treatment technologies, developing methods to purify municipal water supplies and prevent waterborne diseases. His work in chlorination and water treatment laid the groundwork for modern public health practices, significantly improving water quality and helping curb outbreaks of diseases like cholera and typhoid. Another key figure in advancing sanitation was Dan Okun, whose innovations in treatment systems revolutionized the way cities manage sewage and waste, improving environmental protection and public health. His work helped establish the foundation for modern water treatment and wastewater management practices, which continue to be used worldwide. By the late 20th century, sanitation took on a more global perspective. Advances in wastewater treatment, such as filtration systems and chlorine disinfection, became integral in preventing the spread of disease. Cities worldwide, including Chicago with its deep tunnel project, built modern sewage systems to improve public health and manage urban waste. These efforts were supported by international initiatives like the Millennium Development Goals, which sought to reduce the number of people without access to clean water and sanitation by 2015. The World Health Organization and other global health organizations have played a critical role in improving sanitation worldwide, working to provide clean water, sanitation facilities, and education to underserved regions. Their efforts helped make progress toward achieving the MDGs and continue to drive global efforts to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals, specifically Goal 6, which aims to ensure clean water and sanitation for all by 2030. These initiatives have helped reduce the spread of waterborne diseases, improve life expectancy, and elevate sanitation practices in regions that previously lacked basic infrastructure. Now that you know a little bit about the history, let's talk about how sanitation works and why it's important. Sanitation involves the processes of managing water, waste, and hygiene to prevent the spread of disease. At the heart of modern sanitation is a clean water supply, which starts with sources like rivers, lakes, and reservoirs. Water is treated using filtration, chemical disinfection, and sometimes ultraviolet light, to remove harmful pathogens and ensure it's safe for drinking. Once it's clean, water is pumped through extensive piping systems to reach homes, businesses, and schools. Meanwhile, sewage is handled by systems designed to carry waste away from urban areas and safely process it before it re-enters the environment. This involves the use of sewer lines, treatment plants, and in some cases, advanced technologies that turn waste into fertilizer or energy. While this sounds straightforward, it takes a lot of planning and coordination. Cities and municipalities must maintain vast infrastructure and continually adapt to growing populations and climate change. Modern sanitation is also closely linked to public health policy and international efforts that focus on ensuring equitable access to clean water and sanitation worldwide, addressing both local and global challenges to improve public health and quality of life. Ensuring everyone has access to proper sanitation is key to preventing diseases, improving life expectancy, and creating healthier communities worldwide. Whether it's through advanced filtration systems or better waste management practices, sanitation is one of the cornerstones of public health and well-being. Remember, our progress in sanitation has not only shaped the way we live, but has saved countless lives. Stay informed, stay healthy. We'll be right back.